One of the most dangerous phases in hardware manufacturing doesn't feel dangerous. It feels like progress. You've got the prototype, you've locked in a quote, your investor's asking for ship dates. But the second you step into the handoff phase, when your product goes from design to the actual factory floor, that's when you're standing on thin ice. This is where most teams lose control and crumble. Not dramatically, but quietly, silently, through 1,000 small yeses. If I had $1.2 million wired to my account and I was 60 days out from production, here are 5 exact things that I would do to keep my product from getting rewritten. Number one, co-creation is a test. First, I would treat my contract manufacturer like a co-creator, but I'd watch every suggestion they make like a loyalty test. Because when they say, this wall's too thin, we need to change this connector, tolerance is a bit tight here, what they could actually be doing is testing you to see if, do you have the data? Do you understand your own spec? Will you fold if they push back? I'll tell you this, if you fold now, you lose leverage before a single mold is even cut. Number two, stress test before they do. I would tear down my own design before the suppliers and supply chain even have the chance to. I'd simulate every kind of failure I don't want to discover in post-production. What happens under thermal expansion? Can the connector survive being torqued in sideways during install? What's the actual performance margin at 10,000 units? Because if I can't answer those, I just handed the factory the right to make changes without me. Number three, control your BOM before they control you. I'd walk into the call with the factory having BOM leverage. If you don't know your backup components, your sourcing options, or your cost tolerances, it's possible that they will quietly substitute parts to make their life easier. And then, when your product fails in the field, you'll be told, that's what was available. I don't wait for that. I flag anything that is near EOL, I map local suppliers, I model price swings in advance. If you don't have BOM control, you simply just don't have product control. Number four, lock veto rights before anything is built. Lock rights in writing. No silent swaps. No, we thought it was fine. I've seen entire product launches get derailed because one line item on the BOM changed and no one told the founder. Look, it's simple. If my name's on the PO, I get a say on every single change or the build doesn't move forward. Put it in your contract. And finally, number five, test their transparency before you need it. Test them before they even touch the tooling. Send them a known flaw and watch how they find it. How do they test for fatigue? How do they catch out of spec parts? Because if their process can't find a planted issue, it won't catch a real one that you missed it when it matters. You're probably noticing a pattern in all 5 of these points. To me, it is be prepared, know your product inside out, be conscious about what you need and what you want. If you have all of those things, stuff's not getting replaced without your permission. And when it does need to get replaced, you'll know the reason for it, and you'll be able to have an open conversation or a negotiation if needs be to make those decisions in a way that won't hurt you, your business, or your product launch. We've seen teams lose 9 months and 70K, 100K, 150K from a tolerance change that seemed minor but broke performance under load. It's rarely one big mistake. It's a quiet series of handoffs where no one says anything until your product isn't even yours anymore. If you're in this phase and you want to check your blind spots, comment DFM below. I'll send you the teardown checklist we give funded teams before anything gets transferred. It's helped save hundreds and hundreds of thousands of dollars in rework and kept our customers and their products exactly how they designed it. See you in the next one. Peace.